Reaching out to both sides of the aisle, President Trump is hosting a bipartisan dinner tonight, hoping to tackle tax reform with both Republicans and Democrats. Will it work? Here now is Madison Gesiotto, Washington Times columnist and an advisor to the National Diversity Coalition for Trump. What do you think of this move?
I think it's really important that we have bipartisan support heading into tax reform. I mean, as we saw with health care, having 52 Republicans in the Senate just is not enough. Republicans can't seem to get anything done on their own. And this is a bipartisan issue. This is something that affects Republicans, Democrats, and we should all be on the same page. We want to see tax cuts and tax reform.
Right, but you have to wonder where the common ground is. I mean, I appreciate the approach, the idea that, you know, the other way, going with the Republicans wasn't working, wasn't getting him anywhere. And the president does not seem to be a member of any party in particular. I mean, that's one of the things that people liked about him. But at the same time, where's the common ground in terms of what they can agree on in the tax code?
Well, I think we need to look to middle-class Americans, and these are the people that need relief. Looking forward to 2018, many of the Democratic senators are going to be in toss-up elections. And so three of the senators that are going to be at the dinner tonight are Democrats up for re-election in 2018 in states that President Trump won last year. And so I think they're going to have to really take this pressure, and they're going to have to step forward and do something about this, because I think they are in jeopardy of losing their seats if they don't.
I mean, the irony is they could come together on an idea to, I mean, maybe raise taxes on the limousine liberals. You know, the people at the very high end of the earnings spectrum tend to be Democrats these days, the 1%. And it would be ironic to see them all come together to raise taxes on that group if they did to, quote unquote, pay for tax cuts on other groups, you know, perhaps the middle class. But the fundamental principle, Democrats want to grow the size of government. Republicans, and I think the president, they want the swamp drain. They want it smaller. So it seems like it would be hard for them to find very much common ground.
Well, I think it's definitely going to be difficult. No one ever said it's going to be easy, but it's something that the president will not stop until he gets accomplished. And once he's done with this, I think he'll go back and revisit health care as well. These are important issues. They're affecting Americans. And when we go to the complexity of our tax code, I mean, that's something that needs reform for every American, no matter what tax bracket you're in. It's too difficult, you know, and it just wastes time. It wastes money. And yeah, it's not something that we can continue to move forward with productively.
Does he alienate Republicans by courting Democrats like this?
Well, I don't think he should. And if he does alienate congressional Republicans, once again, I think we'll look to those districts or, you know, to those Senate seats in 2018 as well. In states like Ohio with Senator Rob Portman. I'm from Ohio. He's done a lot of great things for the state. But I think as a citizen of Ohio, it's really important for us to see him step forward and make the right decision on tax reform and tax cuts.
All right, Madison, thank you.